We paid a heavy price, but the trap worked.
You seem surprised.
It's been a while since we've had a win. How long will it hold?
I've never entrapped a being like this, but the bonds hold, for now.
How do we dispose of it?
I'm just a witch. You're the soldier.
If it bleeds, I can kill it.
How do you kill a spirit, though?
If you kill the mortal vessel while it's bound, the spirit may perish within. If it escapes...
It's listening to us.
What are you?
Others of your kind, nameless, ethereal.
Why have you invaded our world?
Your world. We existed first, and were managed by your corrupt gods. Your pocket opened the way, and now we return to reclaim what by right should be ours.
I've heard enough of this rubbish. Let's hang it.
Destroy this vessel, and I will find another. I have tasted its desires and emotions. Your kind is weak. You have already lost this war.
Do it.
Captain!
Cut him down!
What? Are you mad? Better safe than sorry.
The spirit has fled!
This is a human now.
The captain is correct. When they awaken, they won't remember a thing.
The ethereal was right. The war is lost. We're a resistance now, and we need every human survivor we can call to our cause. Maybe this one here can still die with some honor. If they ever wake up, send them to me. If they don't, bury him deep with the others.
Still drawing breath, I see. You're one lucky bastard, I'll give you that. Best go speak to Captain Bourbon right away. He seems to have a plan for you now that we've spared your life. You were possessed, so we strung you up. Seems the spirit fled your body before your life ran out. I'd have left you to hang, but the captain had other plans. He sees some purpose in you, and I'm not going to argue. He's, up the road, in the courtyard. Don't make me regret cutting you down.
You're not looking too bad for someone just come back from the brink of death. You were taken, possessed by the same creatures that have been reanimating these zombies here. Normally I'd have burned you with the rest to be safe, but we've lost too many people to the dead. I need someone expendable. Someone with nothing to lose, but a lot to gain. Right now, you're that person. Prove your worth to me, and the survivors of Devil's Crossing may just welcome you. The bodies of the dead are rising again in some horrible unlife. Corpses don't just get up and move around on their own. Something is reanimating our deceased with ethereal energy. We have observed the dead for some time, and they appear to be flooding Lower Crossing from the burial hill, just beyond town. I want you to go to the burial hill, find whatever is controlling these abominations, and destroy it. You will need to fight your way through Lower Crossing. Once you've crossed the stream on the far side of town, there will be a beaten path leading up to Burial Hill. I know I'm asking a lot of you, but I'd be asking a lot of my people to welcome you with open arms, too. Help us in our hour of need, and I will open Devil's Crossing to you.
Thank you.
The dead attacks have slowed and their numbers are thinning. I take that as a sign that you've dealt with the source? A creature was doing this? Disturbing. Thanks to your efforts, we may yet hold out here a little longer. I've sent word to the gate guard. Speak to him and he should let you in. Take some well-deserved time to rest and recover. Well, I need some time to plan our strategy. In the meantime, there are others around Devil's Crossing who could use your help. Take a moment to mingle with your fellow survivors. Kasparov, our resident scientist, is really eager to speak with you. He babbled some nonsense, but I believe he wants to talk about your connection with the Aetherials. Barnabas, our handyman, said he needed help with our water pump. When you're done assisting them, speak with me in my office inside the prison.
Welcome to my workshop. I saw you fighting the dead out in Lower Crossing, and I dare say you are absolutely brilliant. Evidently, cutting you off that noose was the best decision the captain made that day. Where are my manners? I'm Kasparov, scientist and inventor. What brings you to my humble shop? Rift gates, yes. The Aetherials use them to get around. I was working on a way to close them, but then you stumbled through ours. We have never seen a human, possessed or otherwise, pass through one before. Not a living one, anyway. It was then that I realized that we could put these portals to use. There's something about you that is attuned to the Rift Gates, and I intend to replicate it. You don't remember anything, do you? I may have taken some liberties while you were out cold. It was just a few tests, a blood sample or two, nothing major. The results were curious. It appears that your body is still teeming with residual Aether energies. Don't worry, you won't be growing any new limbs, probably. But I'm going on tangents here. I believe that with a correctly tuned pulse of Aether energy, we can replicate this phenomenon in a controlled manner, as in, without the need for pesky possession. I've been working on just the device to do it, but it needs power. For that, I require Aether crystal fragments. Excellent. These will do perfectly. I'll just place them into the device here and... Oh my, that's not right. Not at all. That pulse, it wasn't supposed to go off. Oh dear. 1, 2, 3. Yes, my fingers are still intact. Did it reach you too? How do you feel? Ah, very good. I'm sure a little more Aether in your system won't do you the slightest harm. Okay, maybe it was a lot more. But you look fine. Fitter than ever. Real shame about the prototype, though. Showed such promise. Perhaps if I had more fragments. We've been so preoccupied with this Rift Gate business that I completely forgot about my apprentice, Darlet. I sent her out to the Burwich Estates to fetch parts for our research, and she's been gone entirely too long. Seems her ineptitude carries beyond just the workstation. I have to say, I do feel a little responsible for her now that she is my apprentice. Could you please go out there and find that hopeless girl?
Send you over? He must have done quite a service with the dead if he's got hands to spare for old Barnabas. Let's get to business, yeah? Our wind pump's broken down again and we're running low on water. We're all out of parts, so I can't fix her up. Can always melt down what weapons we have, but I'm not too fond of being fired in my sleep. I'll need scrap from Lower Crossing. Have you seen the bodies floating out there? Surface water around here is rank with disease and decay. Our only hope is the well. Now, you can get some scrap, or do I have to settle for sass? Search the ruined houses and the old dumping grounds on the far side of Lower Crossing, past the burial hill. Smash some junk. Search the bodies of those things roaming around out there. Where you get it isn't that important to me, just that you get it soon. Running out of drinking water. Nothing to be said about ever taking a bath with you.
I'll see what's left of my wares.
Greetings, child. I am pleased to see that the taint of possession has left you. Should you require it, I offer spiritual guidance to the survivors. I will gladly extend this service to you. My knowledge of spirits has allowed me to devise a trap with which we were able to contain you and the ethereal that controlled you. It was not until the noose was firmly around your neck that the spirit left you, though. I'm afraid that I am not at all fit for combat, which from my understanding was more than necessary for you to reach the reanimator's lair. I was only able to subdue the ethereal within you with the use of a trap, which would have required the reanimator to come to us, just as you have. Troubled memories can cloud the mind and torment the spirit. With my guidance, you can move past these painful thoughts and begin anew.